To begin, choose the yarn of your choice, the hook of your choice, a scissors, and a darning needle. Don't forget your stitch marker. You will begin with a magic ring. When you complete your magic ring, you will do 6 single crochets into the center of your magic ring. Pull your magic ring tight and making sure you count 6 stitches when your magic ring is pulled tight. For row 2, you will do 1 increase in each stitch. This would create 12 stitches. For row 3, place your stitch marker, then do 1 single crochet, followed by 1 increase. You will repeat this 6 times for a total of 18 stitches. Thank you. For row 4, you will do 2 single crochets followed by 1 increase and repeat this 6 times for a total of 24 stitches. For row 5, you will do 3 single crochets followed by 1 increase, and you will repeat this 6 times for a total of 30 stitches.
Thank you.
For rows 6 through row 10, you will do a single crochet in each stitch for a total of 30 stitches, working continuously around in a circle. For row 11, place your stitch marker and do 3 single crochets followed by 1 decrease, and do this 6 times for a total of 24 stitches. Thank you. For row 12, place your stitch marker. You will do 2 single crochets followed by 1 decrease and repeat this 6 times for a total of 18 stitches. When you have completed row 12, stuff the head firmly with some soft stuffing. For row 13, you will do 1 single crochet, followed by 1 decrease. Do this 6 times for a total of 12 stitches. For rows 14 and 15, single crochet in every stitch around for a total of 12 stitches. Thank you. For row 16, you will do one increase followed by two single crochets. Do this four times for a total of 16 stitches. For row 17, single crochet all the way around in each stitch for a total of 16 stitches. For row 18, do 2 increases, followed by 6 single crochets, followed by 2 increases, followed by 6 single crochets, for a total of 20 stitches. Thank you. For row 19, do 2 increase stitches, followed by 8 single crochet, followed by 2 increase stitches, followed by 8 single crochet, for a total of 24 stitches. For rows 20 and 21, do single crochet in each stitch for a total of 24 stitches. For row 22, you will do 10 single crochets, followed by 2 increase, followed by 10 single crochets, followed by 2 increase. Thank you. For rows 23 through rows 25, single crochet in each stitch all the way around for a total of 28 stitches.
Thank you.
For row 26, you will do 13 single crochet, followed by one increase, followed by 13 single crochet, followed by one increase. Thank you. For rows 27 through 30, single crochet in each stitch for a total of 30 stitches. When you complete row 30, stuff the body firmly.
Thank you.
For row 31, this starts the first leg. You will do 14 single crochets. Skip number 15. You will go across to where you started the first single crochet of the 14 and single crochet in that stitch to join together to make the first leg hole. For rows 32 through 33, you will be working in the first leg only, doing a single crochet in every stitch for a total of 15. For row 34, you will do 3 single crochet followed by 1 decrease, and do this 3 times for a total of 12 stitches. For rows 35 through row 67, you will do a single crochet in each stitch all the way around for a total of 12 stitches to complete the first leg. When you get to row 68, you will decrease all the way around to close off that leg for a total of 6 stitches. For the second leg, begin back at the top of the leg. You will start again with row 32 through 33, single crochet in each stitch for a total of 15. When you get to row 34, you will do 3 single crochets followed by 1 decrease and do that 3 times for a total of 12. For rows 35 through 67, single crochet in each stitch for a total of 12 stitches. When you get to row 68, you will decrease all the way around for a total of 6 stitches. When you complete the last leg, cut the thread, needle around each stitch, and pull closed. You have now completed the head, the body, and two legs. Set your work aside to begin on two arms. You will make two arms using two identical patterns. Begin with a magic circle with six single crochets in the circle. Thank you. For row 2, you will do 1 single crochet followed by an increase, and do this 3 times for a total of 9 stitches. For rows 3 through 24, single crochet in each stitch for a total of 9 stitches. When you reach row 25, pinch the work in half and single crochet along the bottom to close off one arm. To make the angel wings, you will make 2 pieces. Begin with the magic circle with 6 single crochets. Row 2 will be an increase in each stitch for a total of 12. Row 3 will be 1 single crochet followed by an increase. Do this 6 times. Row 4 will be 2 single crochets followed by an increase. Do this 6 times for a total of 24. Row 5 through row 7 will be a single crochet all the way around for a total of 24 stitches. Row 8 will be 2 single crochets followed by a decrease, and do this 6 times. Row 9 will be a single crochet in each stitch all the way around. Row 10 will be 1 single crochet followed by 1 decrease, and do this 6 times. Row 11 will be a single crochet all the way around in each stitch for a total of 12. Row 12 will be a decrease all the way around 6 times. Row 13 will be a single crochet all the way around for a total of 6. You now have 2 wings. It is time to assemble your angel. You will take the head, the body, and the legs, the 2 arms, and the 2 wings, and sew each piece on, beginning with the arms. You will connect the arms just below the head on the back of the body, wrapping the arms around so that the hands can meet in the front. These hands will be sewn together so that the legs can bend and tuck in the arms. Thank you. It is time to sew your angel wings on. You will sew them on just over the back of the arms. Try a few places to see where you like it best. When you find where you like it, you will sew each wing on over the seam of the arms.
Thank you.
Prior to sewing your hands, fold the legs up to see how wide or how thin you need your arms to be. Wrap the arms around the legs, then you will sew your hands together. Once you sew the hands together, you can choose if you want to sew in the legs or leave the legs free. I typically sew the legs in so that it is a sitting angel at all times. Thank you. angel is complete. I hope you enjoy the video. Please like and subscribe.